Good morning, children. Let us discuss, let us see the example 18. So observe here, they are given this question depending on change, percentage change. So just observe, cost of an article goes down every year by 20%, means decreasing. Okay, cost of article is decreasing by 20% every year. And find its original cost if the cost of it after 2 years is 19,200. See, given original cost is becoming 19,200 after 2 years. Okay, after 2 years, at the end of, at the beginning of third year, otherwise at the end of second year, yes or no? So first of all, let the original cost as an article is equal to X rupees. Okay, and given it becomes 19,200 rupees after 2 years. That is nothing but at the end of second year. After 2 years means at the end of second year. And every year, so it is also given that every year cost is reduced by 20% of previous value. So let cost at the beginning of first year is equal to 100 rupees. It is goes down by 20% of previous value. So therefore, cost at the beginning of second year is equal to 100 rupees minus 100 rupees minus 20% of 100. That is 20% of 100 is 20/100 into 100. So 20 rupees will get. That means 100 minus 20, which is nothing but 80. So directly I am writing 80 rupees. 100 minus 20, which is nothing but 80 rupees. Okay. At the beginning of first second year, that means at the end of first year. Now, after 2 years means at the end of second year, we need to find that. So therefore, cost at the beginning of third year, that is nothing but at the end of second year is equal to 80 rupees minus 20% of 80 rupees. Previous value only we need to take. Okay, which will be equal to 20% of 80 rupees. That is 20/100 into 80. 0 will get cancelled. 0 will get cancelled. 8 to the 16. So 16 rupees it will be there. That is 80 minus 16, which is nothing but 64 rupees. Okay, now consider the ratio of original prices as well as this one. Okay, so just observe the ratio. So ratio of original price is equal to ratio of cost after 2 years. So that will be equal to original price is x and 100. So x is to 100. And after 2 years, that value is becoming 19,200 is to 64. For x, 19,200 is after 2 years value. And for 100 rupees, after 2 years, it is becoming 64. Now take the product of means is equal to product of exchange. Then what will you get? X will be equal to, so here I am doing x into 64 equal to 19,200 into 100. So x will be equal to by 64 will come. 4 4s are 16, 4 25s are 100. 4 1s are, sorry. 4 16s are 64. Then 4 4s are 16. 4 4s are 16, 4 8s are 32. 2 zeros are there. And then 64. 4 1s are 4 6s are 4 4s are 16. Okay, 32. 4 8s are 32. 2 0s are there. Again, 4 4s are 16. 4 1s are 4 2s are 4 1s are 4 3s are 300. We got 300 into 100 is nothing but 30,000 rupees is the actual price. Okay. See, already this question I have explained in our previous class also. So once again, observe this. It is given that the original cost is decreasing for every year by 20%, and after 2 years, its cost will be becoming 19,200. So at the starting price X, and after 2 years, it is becoming 19,200 actual price, and it is after 2 years price. If we are taking by using proportion, I am taking actual price as 100 rupees. For that, after 2 years, I am getting 64 rupees. So it is very clear that at ratio of, by using proportion, ratio of actual prices must be equal to ratio of cost after 2 years. So that will be actual price at, for 19,200 rupees is X, and 100 rupees by using proportion we are doing. So X is 200 must be equal to, when X we are taking after 2 years, it is becoming 19,200. So 19,200 is to 64. The 64, how we got? Because they are given percentage change is 20%. It is decreasing. So actual value is 100. And for the next year, it is becoming 100 minus 20% of 100. So 20% of 100 is 20. 100 minus 20 is 80 rupees. And for the next year, original price will become 80. In that, 20% is 16. So 80 minus 16 is 64. This is after 2 years cost. So after 2 years, this one and original cost are these. By simplifying that, we are getting actual price of the article as 30,000 rupees. Now coming to the next example, 19. Okay, observe the given problem. See, whenever they are given like this problem, first of all, whatever they are given values, identify and note them. After that, which formula is related to them, that formula you must use. So previous only I have given the formulas related to profit, loss and discount. Those three, if you are learning perfectly, no need to go for proportion method also. Directly use the formulas and simplify the question. Now observe the first question. A shopkeeper marks his goods, marks given means marked price. This question is depending on, observe, read the complete question. Marks his goods 25% above the cost price and allows a discount of 12%. Discount percentage is given. What percent does he gain? So for that we need to find out a gain. See, first of all, let us, cost price not given. So I am taking 100 rupees. Let's cost price is equal to 100 rupees. Cost price of the goods. And given market price is equal to 25% above the cost price. That means cost price is 100 rupees and 25% of 100 rupees we must take. Whenever you are taking about 100, you will get same number. 25 by 100 into 100, 25 rupees you will get. That will be equal to completely 100 plus 25 rupees, which is nothing but 125 rupees. So directly we can write instead of all this. Just write above means plus. So cost price is 100 rupees and 25 rupees above the cost price is 25. Plus 25, which will be equal to 125 rupees will be the market price. CP is 100, MP is 125 rupees. Now, given discount percentage is equal to 12%. From this, find out discount. We have discount percentage is equal to discount by MP into 100. So MP value is there, discount percentage is there. From that, find out the value of discount, rupees, percentage given. So we need to find out how many rupees they are given the discount. Discount is equal to, it is discount percentage. Discount percentage of MP. By 100. See, we have discount percentage is equal to discount by MP into 100. We need to find out discount. Bring every term this side. So that is discount percentage into MP by 100. Okay, this formula also we have. Just check it in the given formulas about discount. Okay. Now which will be equal to discount percentage is 12 into MP is 125 divided by 100. So instead of going cancelization, multiply these two numbers and after that, just before two digits, keep the point. You will get the answer in easiest way. 12 5s are 60. Okay. 12 2s are 24 plus 6, 30. 12 1s are 12. 12 plus 3 is 15. By 100. Two zeros will get cancelled. Therefore, discount is equal to 15 rupees. Now, MP and discount is there. They are asking to find out gain percentage. Yes or no? To get gain, if we have CP and SP, we can able to find. CP, we have 100 rupees. We need to find out SP. To get SP, we need already market price is there, discount is there. So, SP is nothing but MP minus discount. SP will be equal to MP minus discount. To get SP value, we are doing all this. So, therefore, SP is equal to MP value is 125 and discount is 15 rupees. That is nothing but 110 rupees. Okay. So, it is SP. Now, therefore, gain. Find out gain first. SP minus CP. That is 110 minus 100 rupees, which is equal to 10 rupees. Gain equal to 10 rupees we got. Therefore, gain percentage of gain they are asking is equal to gain by CP into 100. See how many formulas we are using to get only single answers. So, which is equal to 10 by CP of the object is 100, which is equal to 100. 100 will get cancelled, so 10%. Okay, now once again observe the question. Here they have given that shopkeeper marks his goods 25% above the cost price, and cost price I'm taking is 100 rupees above the cost. MP will be 25% above the cost price. That's why 100 plus 25, which is nothing but 25% of cost price is 100. We will get 25 only. So 100 plus 25 is 125 rupees. And discount percentage is given, that is 12%. From that we are getting discount by using this formula. After getting MP and discount, find out SP by using the formula MP minus discount. Because we need to find out gain percent. To get gain, we must know SP. So gain is equal to SP minus CP, which is equal to 10 rupees. Because CP is 100, 10% we will get gain percentage also. So gain percentage is equal to 10%. Gain by CP into 100. Listen here, we will get the questions depending on profit, loss, profit percent, loss percent, and discount and discount percentage. Okay, all those formulas, whatever we have discussed previously, all those formulas you need to learn. With that, we can do the each and every problem. So now observe the first question. A shopkeeper. A shopkeeper bought a suitcase for ₹480 and sold it for ₹540. Find his gain percent. Okay, observe the problem. Whatever values are given, first know them. A shopkeeper bought a suitcase for ₹480. Bought is nothing but buying amount. Buying amount is nothing but CP. So given CP of suitcase is equal to ₹480. And sold it for ₹540 and sold selling price, that is SP is equal to ₹540. Now find his gain percent. Actually here they have mentioned gain percent. Percentage gain we need to find, means first find out gain, after that gain percent. But some cases they won't mention whether he is getting gain or loss. So we need to decide whether he is getting gain or loss. So just observe here, he is getting SP is more than CP, yes or no? So when SP is more than CP, that means SP by CP is greater than 1. In that case, we will get profit. Therefore, the profit is given by gain equal to SP minus CP. First of all, find out the gain, after that gain percent. Okay. So gain will be equal to ₹540 minus ₹480, which is equal to ₹60. Okay, ₹60 gain he is getting, but they didn't ask not only gain percent also. So gain percentage is equal to, what is the formula for gain percent? Gain by CP into 100. Use that. So gain is ₹60, CP is ₹480 into 100. 00 will get cancelled. 68. 100 by 8 we got. 4 2s are 425. So 25 by 2. 25 by 2 is nothing but an improper fraction or decimal value, whatever. So what I am taking, decimal value I will take. 25 by 2 is nothing but 2 1s are 2 2s are 12.5%. So gain percentage is equal to 12.5%. Depending on the question answers, you need to take either improper fraction, otherwise decimal, otherwise mixed fraction, depending on the question. Okay. So now once again observe here, observe the given value. Identify which values are given and verify the condition. Here SP is more than CP, that's why he is getting a profit. So profit is given by SP minus CP. Find out how much profit he is getting, but they are asking profit percent. So profit percent formula is given by profit by CP into 100. Profit is nothing but gain also, that's what. Gain percentage is equal to gain by CP into 100. By doing so, we got this one as the answer. And if the answer may be improper fraction or mixed fraction or decimal number also. Okay. Now coming to the second problem. Ajay bought a TV for 15,000 rupees and sold it for 14,100 rupees. Find the last percentage. Find the last percent. Okay, just observe here what are given values and then which one he is getting. So it is given in the question only that last percent. So compulsory he is getting a last. We will check with the values also. Observe that given TV bought for 15,000 rupees. So CP of TV is equal to 15,000 rupees. And sold it for 14,100. So less amount. SP is 14,100. Therefore, CP only greater than SP. So CP by SP is greater than 1. Means he is getting loss. So how much loss he is getting? Loss is equal to difference between CP and SP. Then what will you get? 15,000 minus 14,100. Therefore, loss is equal to 900 rupees. Okay. Loss equal to 900 rupees. And they are asking for last percent. Last percentage is given by loss by CP into 100. Just observe, everything is depending on formula. So, which is equal to 900 divided by CP is 15,000 into 100. So, two zeros will get cancelled, 0, 0 will get cancelled, 15 ones are 15 sixes. 6% of loss he is getting by selling TV for 14,100 rupees. Okay, very simple. And some questions they mention what he is getting, either profit or loss. Here they did directly asking, find the last percent. So, to get the last percent, first we need to know what is the loss. Because CPSP given, so we can find out loss easily. That's why we are using this formula. Okay. Now coming to the third problem. Ramu sold a plot of land for two lakh forty thousand rupees and gaining 20%. For how much did he purchase this flat? For how much did he purchase this flat? Purchase is nothing but, so first of all, what are the given values we will see. Observe that Ramu sold a flat of land for 2,40,000 rupees. Sold given. Sold is nothing but SP. So SP of the flat is equal to 2,40,000 rupees. And gaining 20%. Percentage of gain given means gain percent equal to 20%. Then for how much did he purchase this flat? CP is equal to how much they are asking. Purchase is nothing but buying. So for how much he bought that flat they are asking. So we need to find out the cost price of the flat. Okay. So related to these three terms, which formula is suitable? We have SP is equal to CP into 100 plus profit percent, that is gain percent by 100. Yes. This formula we have. From this substitute all the values, find out CP. Otherwise, from this only I have given the formula. CP is equal to, bring every term this side, SP into 100 divided by 100 plus gain percent. This term reciprocal we will get this side. SP into 100 by 100 plus gain percent. That's it. Substitute each and every value you will understand. So first thing was, which values are given, which formula is suitable, that's all. Here SP gain percent given, asking for CP, and these three terms are related with this formula. From this we are having so therefore CP will be equal to SP is 2,40,000 into 100 by 100 plus gain percent, that is 100 plus 20, 120 will get. So we'll write 100 plus 20 in bracket. Okay, so that is nothing but here I am doing the calculation. CP will be equal to 2,40,000 into 100 by 100 plus 20 is 120. So 0, 0 will get cancelled, 12 ones are, 12 twos are 24 and 3 zeros are there. And here two zeros, totally five zeros. That means 2 lakh. CP, cost price of the flat is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. So that is 2 lakh. Okay. Very simple question. If you know the formula, very simple. If we don't know the formula, so first we need to find out a gain by using gain percent from that CP. So that is very lengthy procedure. You can take CP as X, from that find out gain. After getting gain, find out by using the formula SP, gain is equal to SP minus CP, you will get in terms of X. So that will be very lengthy problem. Instead of that, this is very easy if you know the formula. That's why learn the formula. So here I will show in another way how we are simplifying this question. Let CP is equal to X rupees. Okay, given gain percentage is equal to 20%. So we have gain percentage is equal to gain by CP into 100. From this gain equal to gain percentage of CP. Leave it. Now gain percent, substitute all the values. Gain percentage is equal to 20. Gain we don't know, we need to find. Divided by CP we took as X into 100. So gain will be equal to 20 into X by 100. This 100 by bringing gain value. X is in denominator by bringing this side. So by bringing this side divided by 100. So 21s are 25s are. X by 5 rupees is a gain. Okay. Then we have SP. So gain formula we have SP minus CP. Okay, so substitute all the values. Gain value we got X by 5 is equal to SP value is given 2,40,000 minus CP value is X. We have taken as X. Now bring X term one side. X by 5 plus X is equal to 2,40,000. Okay, then go through with the cross multiplication. 1 into X, X, X plus 5, 5X, total 5X plus X is equal to 6X by 5 we will get. So directly I get this. 2,40,000. Then X will be equal to 2,40,000. Into 5 by 6. Reciprocal of 6 by 5 is 5 by 6 by bringing this side. Then 6 ones are 6, 4s are 24 and 4 zeros we have. 4 5s are 20 and 4 zeros. So completely 5 zeros we are getting. That is nothing but 2 lakhs. See, same question we are doing in another way. But it is very lengthy. That's why remember this formula. Okay. So like this also we can do. CP as X, from that because they are given gain percentage and SP, gain percent, by using gain percent, I am getting gain value in terms of CP. After that, gain is equal to SP minus CP, SP value we know and CP we have taken as X and the gain value we got as X by 5. So bring X terms one side, after that find out X value, X is nothing but a CP. Okay, and by using proportion method also we can do this, but easiest way this one. So we will further do all problems by using the formula. So it is better to learn the formula. Now next fourth problem. I'm selling a mobile. Selling a mobile for 7. A shopkeeper loses 10%. For what amount should he sell it to gain 5%? So here two questions are there. Actually, first whatever given answer. Observe that given and selling a mobile means SP of the mobile is equal to 750 rupees given and loss is 10%. So by selling this amount, he is getting a loss of 10% percentage of loss given. Okay. Then for what amount should he sell? Again, SP only asking to gain 5%. Gain percent to become, instead of loss, he must get gain of 5%. Then how much, for what amount he must sell that mobile there. So first of all, find out by using these two values, CP. After getting CP, find out SP value by taking CP and gain percent. So we have the formula SP, CP and loss percent. SP equal to CP into 100 minus loss percent. When profit is given, plus we will get by 100. That's it. This one only the change. Substitute all the values and find out. So therefore, SP is 750 rupees equal to CP we need to find into 100 minus last percentage is 10 by 100. Okay. Then 750 into C is equal to CP into 90 by 100. Two zeros will, zero zero will get cancelled. So therefore CP will be equal to 750 into 9 by 10 by bringing this at 10 by 9. Reciprocal we must take. Then what will you get? Three threes are 9. Three twos are 6. Three fives are 15. And 1 0. And so 2500 by 3 is the CP. So 3 8s are 24, 10 will get, 3 3s are 9, 10, 3 3s are 9, 8, 33.33 we will get, that means, so CP of the one, 833 rupees approximately I am taking. Then find out, take this CP. CP we got 833 rupees. Keep this one like this only, 2,503 rupees CP. So directly we will substitute here. And gain percentage is equal to 5%. So now use SP, we need to find out SP. Is equal to CP into 100 plus gain percent by 100. When gain percentage is given, plus we have to take. When last percentage is given, minus we need to take. That's all. So which is equal to CP we got 2500 by 3 into 100 plus gain percent, 100 plus 5 by 100. So which is equal to 2500 by 3 into 105 by 100. Two zeros will get cancelled. Three ones are, three threes are 9, 15, three fives are 15. 25 into 35. Therefore, SP will be equal to 25 fives are 125 will get. 25 threes are 75. 75 plus 2, 77, 87. 875 rupees will be the SP.